कल्याणी, कैन यू प्लीज टेक मी? वॉइस नॉट ऑडिबल, इट्स इन म्यूट. ऑटो ऑपरेट. Voice is audible, Kalyani. Now audible. Okay. Then we can start. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for the response. Yesterday, some noise pollution, clarity was not there. Now it is okay. There is no noise, no? Hope today there is no noise. పక్కా సార్, అప్ప దివ్య ఇస్ వన్ అండ్ ఓన్లీ పర్సన్ టు రెస్పాన్స్ ఇమీడియట్లీ. గుడ్. వెరీ ఫైన్ జెనిఫర్, థ్యాంక్ యూ జెని. చౌరు, థ్యాంక్ యూ. శివ, వెల్కమ్. Asha, no audible, thank you. Yamini, welcome Yamini. Good. So based on student suggestion only, new mic. I think students are still sleeping. Many students not yet come. What happened? Naveen Kumar, thank you, Ganna. It's my pleasure. Ajay, happy morning. Ajit, good morning, good morning. Soy, thank you, Ganna, thank you. Good morning, Prashad. Thanks for support. Good morning, sir. Good morning, Kanna. Yuvaraj, good morning. What to do? Yes, Indian. Good morning. Few students are sending, not able to connect. What happened? Good morning, Kanam. C.A. Manoj, happy morning. Yes. Rajesh, good morning. Venkatram, happy morning. Yes. Welcome. Now only students are started coming. Likes also. Thank you. Getting late. Why students? Rosia, Eston, good morning, yeah. Why morning time is not suitable for students? வெரி புவர் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் டுடே. குட் மார்னிங் கண்ணா. கொரோனா கெனாட் ஸ்டாப். ஓகே சாய், வில் ட்ரை வில் ஆல் பெஸ்ட். வில் வெயிட் ஃபார் அனதர் 2 மினிட்ஸ். வை டுடே வெரி லெஸ் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ். மார்னிங் இஸ் த பெஸ்ட் டைம் டு ஸ்டடி. எஸ் கல்யாணி, பட் டுடே வெரி புவர் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ். வாட் ஹேப்பன்? ஸ்டூடெண்ட் ஸ்லீப்பிங் ஸ்டில். சிவா, குட் மார்னிங். எக்கனாமிக்ஸ் ஃபினான்ஸ் ஐ டோன்ட் நோ கண்ணா. சிவா ஜே, லாஸ்ட் மிஸ்டர் பரத் சார் டு டேக் எக்கனாமிக்ஸ் ஃபார் ஃபினான்ஸ். ஐ நோ ஓன்லி எஃப்எம். குட் மார்னிங் ஜி கே. தேங்க்யூ. தேங்க்யூ பிரியங்கா, ஹவ் எ நைஸ் டே. மது, குட் மார்னிங். அட்வான்ஸ் அக்கௌண்ட்ஸ், ஐ கான்ட் அட்வான்ஸ் அக்கௌண்ட்ஸ் என்றால் ஷண்முகன் வில் டேக் கேர் ஆஃப் அட்வான்ஸ் அக்கௌண்ட்ஸ். சி, ஃபேக்கல்டி ரெடி டு சாக்ரிஃபைஸ் த ஸ்லீப். வி ஆர் ரெடி டு கம் அண்ட் டேக் த கிளாஸ். ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் நாட் ரெஸ்பாண்டிங் டுடே. தே ஆர் கம்ஃபர்டபுள் ஒன்லி இன் தி டே டைம். வாட் டு டூ இஃப் யூ ஆர் நாட் என்கரேஜிங்? வி டோன்ட் நீட் டு புட் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா எஃபர்ட். நோ, டூ பேட். குட் மார்னிங் யார். எஸ் சூர்யா, குட் மார்னிங். வருண், ஹாப்பி மார்னிங். அக்ஷயா, அக்ஷயா செட் சம்திங் பிஃபோர் ஐ ஃபினிஷ் ரீடிங். இட்ஸ் வானிஷ். Text me one second, Akshaya. Yeah, getting late. They'll join later. Okay. Okay. Morning will be suitable for him. Yes. Okay, Kanna. It's a time to start already. Getting late. Okay. I would like to respond. And I have to appreciate the students who over wake up in the morning. Ready to attend the class in the early morning itself. Good. So, kindly use sanitizer. that is your benefit as well as for your dependents' benefit. Okay. Whenever time permits, wash your hands, take bath properly. Cleanliness is more important. Social distance you have to maintain within your family member itself. Everything is important. This is for our life only. So, day by day, outside, you know, very critical to live. So, you should be very, very careful. But if you are going to work together, that too separately, that is important. Yeah? Work together separately. Definitely, we can be in the position to what pause this critical situation also. After all, individual responsibility only, it's a testing time for us. Therefore, please be careful. Students, now you should know how to make use of your time. No traveling. Think it of, especially person who doing the articleship or going for the office, you know, getting even a single day leave is not an easy task. How much difficult? Now, we got 21 days. You should be there inside the home itself. So, think in the different manner. Instead of getting panic, think in the different manner. If you are maintain yourself properly in the cleaned manner, you don't need to get worried at all. And at the same time, how to utilize that 24 hours into in the remaining days, 20 days, you have to be very careful. That is more important. If you are going to think in that angle, you don't need to become panic. You don't need to worry about what and all going on in the media. Just you can be in the position to concentrate for preparation. So, how to make use of your time? That is more important. Always spend some time. It's a time for you to contribute something to your family, because there is no traveling time. So, why don't you contribute something? At least for the purpose of cleaning. Okay? So that hygienic manner, if you are going to clean, that will be help for your family person, so that you can be in the position to protect from diseases for your what? Your family persons also. Do some small help. And instead of watching the media, instead of watching the TV, kindly concentrate for your preparation, so that this attempt should be your last attempt. So, good morning all of you. Shall we start? Today, we are going to discuss about financial management. Basic concept of financial management. What do you mean by financial management? Managing the finance is called financial management. What is called financial management? Managing the finance is called financial management. Managing the finance, nothing but managing the money is called financial management. Managing the money, as a businessman, the entire financial management, you have to see as if you are a business person. As a businessman, I want to do business. For that, I need money. As an entrepreneur, I need money. So, what are all the duty I need? What and all I supposed to do? First, I need money. Thereafter, I have to invest the money. So, I need money. I have to collect the money. Thereafter, I have to invest the money so that I can be the person to do the business. Therefore, financial management represents what? Collecting the money and using the money. Collecting the money and using the money is called financial management. There are two basic aspects are there in the financial management. It's a frequently asked 4-mark question. Two basic aspects are there in the financial management. What are all the two basic aspects in the financial management? One is collecting the money, another one is using the money. But if I'm going to say collecting the money and using the money, the terminology may not be proper. Therefore, instead of saying collecting the money and using the money, the collecting the money, we need professional terminology instead of what normal terminology. Therefore, don't say mere collecting the money. Its first one is collecting the money is called procurement of fund. What is that called? Procurement of fund. And using the money is called effective utilization of fund. Therefore, there are two basic aspects are there in financial management. What are they? Procurement of fund and effective utilization of fund. These are all the two basic aspects of financial management.
ப்ரொக்யூர்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் அண்ட் ஐ நீடு மணி ஹவு டு கெட் த மணி ஐ நீடு மணி ஹவு டு கெட் த மணி எய்தர் பை வே ஆஃப் இஷ்யூவிங் ஈக்விட்டி ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் ஆர் பை வே ஆஃப் இஷ்யூவிங் ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் ஆர் பை வே ஆஃப் யூஸிங் வாட் கெட்டிங் லாங் டேர்ம் லோன் அண்ட் ஆர் பை வே ஆஃப் டிபெஞ்சர்ஸ் தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் தி வேரியஸ் வேஸ் ஆர் தட் டு கெட் த மணி ஆஸ் எ பிஸ்னஸ் மேன் ஐ நீடு மணி டு ஸ்டார்ட் த பிஸ்னஸ் நோம் ஹவு டு கெட் த மணி தெர் ஆர் ஃபோர் வேஸ் ஆர் தர் மீன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொக்யூர்மெண்ட் வேஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொக்யூர்மெண்ட் வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தி வேஸ் ஆர் மீன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ப்ரொக்யூர்மெண்ட் பை வே ஆஃப் ஈக்விட்டி ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் பை வே ஆஃப் ப்ரிஃபரன்ஸ் ஷேர் கேபிட்டல் பை வே ஆஃப் லாங் டேர்ம் லோன் அண்ட் பை வே ஆஃப் டிபெஞ்சர்ஸ் தீஸ் ஆர் ஆல் தி வே இன் விச் ஐ எம் கோயின் டு ப்ரொக்யூர் த மணி நவ் பிஃபோர் ஐ எம் கோயின் டு ப்ரொக்யூர் த மணி ஐ ஹவ் டு அனலைஸ் த கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக்ஸ் ஆஃப் சோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபண்ட் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் தட் அக்கௌண்ட் த போர்ஷன் டு ப்ரொக்யூர் Why characteristics I have to analyze? I need money. I want to get the money. From where I can get the money? Suppose I need money urgently. I need 100 rupees urgently. There, from where I can get the money? Manoj is there here. Whether I can get the money from Manoj or from Akshaya or from Divya. So I need money urgently to from where I can be the person to get the money. Even though all of my students or all of my friends rather, I can't the person to get the money from all the person who over is here. I may have the comfortness to get the money from Divya. I may not have the same comfortness with other people. It's purely based on what? It's purely based on comfortness. Even if you need money, you may have the comfortness to get the money from your relative, one person, not from the other people. You may have the comfortness to get the money from one friend, not from the other friend. Therefore, just like that we count the person to procure the fund, in the industry also, before you are going to procure the fund, we have to analyze the characteristics of source of fund. Characteristics of source of fund. What are all the characters are there? There are three characters are there. Risk, cost and control. These are all born three different characteristics of source of fund. What are all the three different characters? Risk, cost and control. Now, with respect to risk, cost and control, high risk goes to which fund? Similarly, high cost goes to which fund? And high control goes to which fund? That we have to analyze. Accordingly only, the procurement will come. So, just like that account the portion to procure the fund, before I am going to procure the fund, I have to analyze the characteristics of source of fund. What are all the characters are there? Risk, cost and control. High risk goes to which high risk goes to which fund? I need a fund. I have to get the fund. Risk, we are going to broadly are going to classify the what funds into own fund and borrowed fund. Own fund represent equity share capital, preference share capital. Borrowed fund either by way of long term loan or debenture. Therefore, while calculating the characteristics of source of fund, high risk goes to which fund? High risk goes to own fund. Okay, high risk goes to own fund or borrowed fund. Here, risk with respect to what?
That or borrowed fund.
Risk with respect to what? Risk with respect to what? Risk represent payment, repayment. Repayment is the criteria. High risk goes to which fund? If I am going to depend on own fund, whether it is risky, or if I am going to depend on borrowed fund, it is risky. If I am going to depend on borrowed fund, always risk. Risk with respect to repayment point of view, you have to say, not by way of interest component. Okay? Risk with respect to repayment point of view. High risk goes to which fund? High risk goes to borrowed fund. Why? If I am going to depend on borrowed fund, any given point of time, I have to repay. Therefore, it's risk only, no? I am having my business. I need 100 lakhs rupees. Suppose I got 100 lakhs rupees from our Manoj. Then, as long as liaison between borrower and giver, myself and Manoj, is good, we can be the person to do the business properly. Suppose small misunderstanding between borrower and giver. Then I have to give back the money, I have to settle the money. If I give back the money, if I am going to settle the money, risk is very high, you know, because collected 100 lakhs rupees may not be there as it is in my what cash in hand. I might have invested in London building, plant and machinery. Therefore, if I am going to depend on borrowed fund, if you want me to repay, then risk is very high. Then my going concern may going to get affect because I have to repay the fund properly. Therefore, going concern may going to get affect if I am going to depend on borrowed fund. Therefore, high risk goes to which fund? Borrowed fund. Second one is what? Cost. High cost goes to which fund? We are in characteristics of source of fund. Risk factor over. Now we have to go for cost. High cost goes to which fund? Cost would represent, in case of one fund, cost represent dividend payment, payment of dividend. In case of borrowed fund, cost represent interest component. Therefore, interest as well as dividend is the criteria. Nobody is going to give the fund at free of cost. Something in return they need. The something in return is called one consideration. Here, somebody is going to give the fund. I have to analyze the characteristics. For that, one of the characteristics is called what? Cost. Between one fund and borrowed fund, which one is costly? Which one is costly? Between one fund and borrowed fund, payment of interest is the cost for the borrowed fund. Am I right? Now, I have to pay interest. Whether I am having profit or not, I have to pay the interest. That's a big problem. But interest component, because of that many students used to write, interest is very costly, borrowed fund is very costly. But, interest is a fixed in nature. Why fixed in nature? Because payment of interest is an optional one. Payment of interest is a fixed in nature. Whether I am going to earn profit or not, I have to pay, that is a different issue. But always, I have to pay the same quantum of the interest. Whether 1 lakh is a profit or 1 crore is a profit, payment of interest remain constant. No? Therefore, interest component is a fixed in nature. But in case of one fund, what is the cost of the company? Dividend is the cost of the company. Dividends are depending upon the profit. 1 lakh profit mean dividend is different. 1 crore profit mean proportionately may going to increase. In that circumstance, which one is costly to the company? Company's point of view, cash flow high in case of one fund cost. Moreover, in case of one fund, there is no tax benefit. Whereas borrowed fund, tax benefit is there. What is called a tax benefit? I am going to pay interest. If I am going to pay interest, in my company's P&L account, debit side I can be the portion to show interest component. If I am going to debit interest component, then accordingly, profit will come down. If the profit is coming down, mean tax also accordingly will come down. Therefore, one hand I am paying interest, another hand I am saving tax. Therefore, net cash flow will be less. But in case of one fund, what is the cost of the company? Payment of dividend. If I am going to pay dividend, dividend is a cash outflow, but I can't show as a expenses, cash expenses, cash paid, dividend paid. I can't the portion to debit in the P&L account, because after profit only, out of profit only, we have to pay dividend. Therefore, we may not in the portion to show dividend as a expenses. Understood or not? Therefore, payment of dividend is always costly when compared to payment of interest. Whatever the characteristic we are going to discuss, what are all the characteristics? Risk, cost and control. Everything we have to see in company's point of view, not in investor point of view. That is important. Shouldn't used to get the confusion. Okay. We have to discuss only in what? Company's point of view, not in investor's point of view. So high cost goes to which fund? Own fund. High risk goes to which fund? Borrowed fund. High cost goes to one fund. The last one is what? Control. High control goes to which fund? Control represents what? Company wants to control. company having better control over own fund holder or borrowed fund holder? So company can have the better control over own fund or borrowed fund holder. Now many of them used to tell own fund means we can have the proper control. Clear? So own fund means we have the proper control. But own fund is nothing but shareholders. Borrowed fund, debenture holder or loan holder, to whom I can have the proper control. Company can have proper control over borrowed fund holder. Company can have what? Proper control over what? Borrowed fund holder. Why? What is the company? Company has to pay interest, no? Clear? And company, once if we paid the interest, that's all, duty over. Borrowed fund holder, I paid interest or not, that's all. There is no locus standi for the borrowed fund holder to control the company's affairs. Clear? Whether company is doing business properly or not, it is none of the business for the borrowed fund holder. But in case of own fund holder, who is the own fund holder? Shareholders. Shareholders only going to control the company. Company cannot be in the position to control the shareholders, because shareholders are owners of the company. Moreover, shareholders having voting rights. Therefore, they are having control over the company. Company cannot in the position to control shareholders. Therefore, high control goes to which fund? High control goes to borrowed fund. Therefore, everything whose point of view? Company's point of view you have to. So, company's point of view we have to what? Discuss. There are three characteristics are there. Nigel or reasoning or not. There are three characteristics are there: risk, cost and control. All of you kindly note it down properly, okay? Whether Akshaya or Srinivas or Nikhil or Nageshwari, Abil, Surya, Yamini, Ramya Sri, kindly note it down, okay? Don't sleep, okay? Parallel you have to note down, then only you can be in the position to bottom. Clear? Now we are in characteristics of source of fund. What are all the characters are there? Risk, cost and control. High risk goes to borrowed fund. High cost goes to, okay, noting down. Very good, Manoj. High cost goes to own fund. And high control goes to which fund? High control goes to company can have the better control over borrowed fund. These are all what? Characteristics of source of fund. Very good, Yamini. Now, listen here. These are all the characteristics of source of fund. Bhunesh, noting. Very good. So we are in what? Financial management. Okay, Akshaya. Okay. Good. Note it down. Good. Now, Nageshwari also note it down. Very good. Now, we are in financial management. Financial basic aspects. What are all the basic aspects? One is procurement of fund. Another one is effective utilization of fund. Good. As of now. Okay, Rajesh. Okay, Ramya. Okay. As of now, we are discussing about procurement of fund. With respect to procurement of fund, either by way of running notes is going on. Very good. Doing, sir. Good. Ram. Very good. Okay. Just listen. Yeah. We are in procurement of fund. With respect to procurement of fund, either by way of own fund or borrowed fund. Own fund, under own fund, either by way of equity share capital or by way of preference share capital. Under borrowed fund, either by way of long-term loan or by way of debenture. Before you are going to procure, we have to analyze the characteristics of source of fund. Karthik, listen. Okay, Dagana. Good. Now, then we have to move into what? Effective utilization of fund. What is called utilization? Procurement of fund and utilization of fund. Effective utilization. Effective utilization of fund represents what? We have to use the fund properly and profitably. We have to use the fund proper as well as profitable manner. Okay? Proper, okay. What is called a profitable manner? Properly also you have to utilize. I have to earn profit also. If I am not going to earn profit, how can I able to survive? Therefore, both are equally important. Properly as well as profitably I have to invest. And why profitably? Another one. Because nobody is going to give the fund at a free of cost. Something in return we need. What is called something in return? Interest component or dividend component. At least for the purpose of repay the interest or dividend, I have to earn profit. No? Therefore, we have to use the fund proper as well as profitable manner. Okay, sir, we can use the fund properly and profitably. Then, Before I am going to use the fund, with a great difficulty, I am going to procure the fund. Before I am going to use the fund, we have to analyze cost-benefit analysis. What do you have to do? Cost-benefit analysis. What is called the cost-benefit analysis? What are the cost of procurement? What are the benefit out of the procurement? The benefit out of the investment? Always you have to see the cost-benefit analysis. I procured the fund. Our T. Karthik has given fund to me. The Karthik has given fund to the extent of what, 100 lakhs. Further, you have to pay 18% interest. Out of the 100 lakhs, I am going to invest the money in the business. Then, out of the business, if I am going to get more than 18% return, then only viable. If I am going to get 20% return out of business, then I can procure from Karthik and invest the same. I can get the return, 20% return on investment, 18% I am going to pay to T. Karthik. So that the difference is called one, my return out of investment, my profit. Therefore, always you have to do one, cost benefit analysis. How much the cost of procurement, how much the benefit out of procurement, that is called one, cost benefit analysis we have to do. Now, if I am going to the cost benefit analysis, always I have to see if there is idle fund, if any, unutilized fund, if any. What is called idle or unutilized fund? I have procured the fund from Karthik 100 lakhs. 100 lakhs is with me. I have invested 75 lakhs. Then remaining money is there. The remaining money, 25 lakhs, I wanted to invest. But due to the 21 days, 144, I can't the person to move. I can't the person to invest. Then whether it is possible for you to invest instead of investing in my business, whether I can... Sorry. Whether I can be the person to invest, whether I can be the person to invest in short-term securities or not, that I have to analyze. Because if the fund has become idle, then there is no use. Because after one particular point of time, I have to pay interest component. Therefore, in between, I have to invest. If there is any idle fund or unutilized fund, I have to invest properly. Clear? That is called one, effective utilization. So, idle fund, if any, I have to analyze, I have to identify, and I have to invest somewhere. Next, who is responsible for the same? Who has to maintain all those things? Who else? Our finance manager. It is the duty of the finance manager whether investment has made properly or not, effective utilization happened properly or not. Clear? Cost benefit analysis. Clear? Procurement is still involves some cost, whether utilized properly or not. Clear? And idle fund, if any, all those things, who has to verify? Our finance manager has to verify. So, duty of the finance manager, whether we have utilized proper manner or not, this is his duty only. Now, I'll sum up. We are in financial management, basic aspects. As of now, we covered one, basic aspects of financial management. So, basic aspects of financial management. Broadly, two basic aspects are there. One is procurement of fund, another one is effective utilization of fund. So, what are all the two basic aspects? Procurement of fund and effective utilization of fund. Okay. So, like you can draw, so that quick revision, it will help you. Procurement of fund and effective utilization. Procurement, again, broadly classified into two types. One is by way of own fund. Another one is by way of borrowed fund, own fund and borrowed fund. Under own fund, you can further classify it into equity share capital and preference share capital. Under borrowed fund, you can classify it into long-term loan and debentures. Long-term loan and debentures. So likewise, if you are going to convert everything into chart format, it will be, Sopana, welcome. It will be what? Useful. So, procurement of fund, own fund and borrowed fund. Under own fund, either by way of equity share capital or by way of preference share capital. Under borrowed fund, long-term loan and debenture. These are all the way in which we have to procure the fund. Then, so any theory if you are going to read, if you are going to study, convert into chart format or bullet point format, that you can, that then only you can have the better clarity, quick revision also possible. Then, own fund, borrowed fund. Again, before you are going to analyze, characteristics of source of fund is important. Then we have to go for characteristics of source of fund. What are all the characters are there? Risk, cost and control. Again, what you have to do? Characteristics of source of fund. Characters broadly classified into risk, cost and control. Similarly, running notes, if you are going to convert into chart format, within what few seconds you can have the quick revision also. That risk, cost, control by way of own fund and by way of borrowed fund. Own fund and borrowed fund classification. Now, so how to convert the chart own fund and borrowed fund? Convert into own fund and borrowed fund. Under risk column, own fund. And which one is costly? Under risk column, high risk goes to which fund? Borrowed fund. Low risk goes to own fund. High cost goes to own fund. Low cost goes to borrowed fund. High control goes to borrowed fund. Low control goes to own fund. So, if you are going to convert into chart, own fund and borrowed fund. Own fund and borrowed fund. Risk, high risk goes to borrowed fund. Low risk goes to own fund. Cost, high cost goes to own fund. Low cost goes to borrowed fund. High control goes to borrowed fund. Low control goes to own fund. Why high cost goes to borrowed fund? High cost for which fund? Borrowed fund. Why high cost goes to borrowed fund? First one, dividend expectation of the shareholders are always higher than interest expectation of the loan holder. Dividend expectation of the shareholders are always higher than interest expectation of loan holder. Another one, dividend no tax benefit, whereas interest means we are having tax benefit. Dividend means there is no tax benefit, whereas interest means we are having tax benefit. So why high cost goes to borrowed fund? First one, dividend expectation of the share. Why high cost goes to not borrowed fund? High cost goes to own fund. Okay, why high cost goes to own fund? One is dividend expectation of the shareholders are always higher than interest expectation of the loan holder. Dividend mean no tax benefit, whereas interest mean we are having tax benefit. These are the two reasons with respect to why high cost goes to own fund. Now, effective utilization of fund, what and all we discuss? We have to use the fund properly and profitably. We have to use the fund proper as well as profitable manner. Why? Procurement is itself involves some cost. Nobody going to give the fund at free of cost. Therefore, we have to use the fund properly and profitably. Procurement is itself involves some cost. Therefore, we have to use the fund proper and profitable manner. Before I am going to invest the fund, we have to do cost benefit analysis. How much the cost of the fund and how much the benefit out of the fund you have to analyze. Ideal fund, if any, you have to verify. So, who is responsible for the same? Finance manager is responsible with respect to the procurement of fund, effective utilization of fund. Finance manager has to take care whether we have utilized the fund properly or not. So, effective utilization of fund, we have to use the fund properly and profitably. Because procurement is itself involves some cost. Cost benefit analysis we have to do. If there is idle fund, if any, how to verify? Finance manager is responsible for the same. Finance manager is responsible for the same. Clear? So, up to this stage, basic aspects of financial management over. So, we started with the FM, ends with the FM. Am I right? Any doubt in basic aspects of FM? Comfortable or not? Basic aspects of financial management. It's an expected question as well as what? Important question for your exam. Hope you enjoyed the basic concept. Am I right? Hope you have taken the proper notes also. Now, shall I go to the next level? Good. Join? Good. Now, slowly, students also joined. Very good. Very much comfortable. Yamini? Good. Shiva? Very good, Kana. Very good, very good. So many students. Sinju? Yes, thank you, Kana. Yes, sir. Satish Kumar? Good. Now, shall we go to the next segment? Prashant T, very good. Pooja Jain, you are also there. Very good. No snacks for me today. Ibrahim, good. Comfortable, sir. Good, good. Now, Sapna Ji, welcome. Pooja used to give snacks during my class time. I'm missing the online class. I can download also. You can send it through email itself. Sumadhi, very good, ma'am. Madhu, welcome. BB Vishwaraj, super sir. Thank you, Kanna. Now, shall we go to the next segment? Yeah, good. Abil, you also. Very good. Much comfortable. Good. Ubel Dharan. Objectives of financial management. What are all the objects are there? There are two objects are there with respect to financial management. One is profit maximization. Another one is wealth maximization. Profit maximization and wealth maximization. Now, objectives of financial management also frequently asked a question, most important question also. Object profit maximization. Between two, which one is more important? Profit is important or wealth is important? Profit is a short-term object. Wealth will comes under long-term object. Profit is a short-term object. Wealth is a long-term object. Yeah, Priyanka, wealth only. Yes, good only. Now, profit is a short-term in nature, whereas wealth is a long-term object. Profit, the term profit is a vague one, but wealth is the one clear-cut. What is wealth? Company's point of view, if you are going to run the business, whether profit is important, everything purely based on common sense only. You don't need that much technical jargon and all. Profit is important or wealth is important? Profit, okay? Profit means, you know, net profit is a profit. Wealth represents what? As an individual, what is our wealth? Land and building is a wealth. Asset is the wealth. What all the asset? Car is a wealth. House property is a wealth. Jewelry is a wealth. But in case of company, what is called wealth? Wealth represents goodwill of the company, credit rating of the company, earning per share of the company. These are all called wealth. So, whether our object for the company is to maximize the wealth or maximize the profit, it's a dilemma, it's a confusing terminology. If you're going to see it from outside point of view, both are equally important, or profit is all confusion will come. Or beginning of the period, we have to concentrate profit, thereafter wealth. Now, between two, which one is most important? Both are important only, there is no doubt. Profit is, it's a long, short-term object. We need a profit, we have to earn profit. But at the same time, ultimately, to do the business, mere profit alone is not the criteria. The purpose behind the business is we have to earn goodwill. We should be the one among the competitor. We have to get, okay, best out of the product. And we should be the benchmarking person in that field. That's why When compared to profit, wealth is more important. When compared to profit, wealth maximization is more important. Profit, if you are going to do the profit, earning profit is a must one. If you are doing business, you should earn profit. Then you are unfit to become an entrepreneur. Okay, but earning wealth is the best one. So which one is best? Wealth maximization is best. Clear? Earning profit is a must and earning wealth is the best. But without profit, we can't earn wealth. Yes, of course. But our object is to earn wealth only. For that purpose only, you are earning profit. Clear? Foundation is important. Our sixth floor is important. Without foundation, we can't the person to construct sixth floor. But we can't the person to stay in the foundation. So foundation is must. Sixth floor is best. Same manner, profit is must. Wealth is best. Or easy way to understand. Suppose, Priyanka, can you please tell me, if you want to, in CA examination, getting the rank is best or clearing all the paper is best? Priyanka, getting the rank is best or clearing all the paper is best? I think Priyanka is sleeping. Surya, you can tell her. Yeah, Priyanka, clearing. Clearing only, clearing all the paper is best. Very good, Priyanka. Which one is best, I am asking? Getting the rank. Manoj is telling getting the rank. Shiva also rank. Many people will have clearing one group itself best for me. That is not the object here. Clear? Which one is really best? Yeah. Ajit, okay. Getting the rank is best. Yes. If you are joining the examination, clearing is a must. Priyanka now got the point. Nageshwari, rank only. You are rank holder, no? That's why done. Good. So, clearing the examination, all the paper clearing the examination is must. Clearing all the paper is must. Getting the rank is the best one. That is logic or not? You can't the person to argue, no, if you want to get the rank, you have to clear all the paper, no? Clear? We are both, always one of both the, because you are having both. Now, clearing the examination, all the paper is must. Getting the rank is best. If you want to get the rank, you have to clear all the paper. But why you join the course? You should clear. Clearing examination is must. Getting the rank is the best. Same manner, if you are doing the business, clearing what? Getting the profit is a must one. And getting what? Wealth is a best one. So between profit maximization and wealth maximization, which one is more important? Wealth maximization is the most important. It's a frequently asked question. Expected and important question also. Objectives. Okay? Good. Thank you, Nageshwari. Now, objectives of financial manager over, aspects of financial manager over, characteristics of source of fund also over. Now, shall I go to the next one? Okay, now, Nageshwari, I am asking question to you. Okay, is it possible for you to respond quickly? Nageshwari Shabari, yes. Are you ready, Nageshwari? Yes, sir. Very good. Priyanka ready. Now, I am talking to Nageshwari now. Nageshwari, are you ready? Okay. Now, can you please tell me, suppose our Nageshwari or Priyanka, whoever is going to come first, yeah, Nageshwari also came. Nageshwari, if you are going to, suppose today onwards, you want to do the business. You want to become a business magnet. Can you please tell me, what are the first step you have to do? You want to become a business magnet, then what are the first step you have to do? What you have to do first? Quick. Investment. Before investment. Procurement of fund. That is investment only, Ajit. Ajitha. No. Procurement. Before that. Pooja is telling correctly. B. Pooja. Planning. Do plan. Manoj also telling the correct one. Very good. Edap pannalum. Plan panni pannanum. Good, Balaji. Yeah. First, what we have to do? Documents. Nageshwari, I will kill you. Okay. Planning. First one is, we have to do what? Planning. So, before you are going to start the business, what you have to do? We have to do plan. What business you have to do? That you have to identify. After doing planning, I have identified you want to do the business. Assume you want to do textile business. So, where you have to do the business? Whether large scale or small scale, which place you want to do the business. Okay, all planning planning process over. Then, after that, what you have to do? We need fund for the purpose of starting the fund. For the purpose of starting the business, you need fund. That is called source of fund. You have to worry about source of fund. After planning process is over, what you have to do? Source of fund. What are the first step you have to do? Plan. Second step, we have to do source of fund. You got the money also. Planning over and you got the money. Then what you have to do? Jennifer Joy, you can tell. Planning over and you got the fund also. What step you have to do next? What are the next thing you have to do? After getting the money. Application of fund. Okay, good. Ramya stream. Application of fund represent what? Investing the fund. Very good, Sapna. Yes. Execution of plan. Very good, Yaman. Yes, utilization only. Allocation, investment. Good, good, good. Then, source of fund we are having. We have to invest. Can you please tell me whether you have to invest in long term or short term or both? Whether you have to invest in long term or short term or both? Investment, correct only. Next question I'm asking. Whether you have to invest in long term or short term or both? Long term, Karthik. Both Kalyani. Shivaji, Jay, both. Yes, both is the correct answer. Mix of both. Mix means in a both. So both. So Priyanka, not only long term. One hand you have to invest in long term. Another hand you have to invest in short term. Today more interactive it seems. Good. So combination of Rajesh. Okay. Yeah. Long term and short term is the correct answer. Okay. Listen here, sir. Now we have to invest in. Depends on the source. Yamini, what happened to you? Okay. After collecting the source of fund, we have to invest. Jennifer is the last person to answer my first question to you. We have to invest in long term as well as short term. Okay. Now, one hand we have to invest in short term. Another hand we have to invest in long term. Investing in short term is called working capital management. Investing in long term is called capital budgeting, also called investment decision. Capital budgeting, also called what? Investment decision. Then you are doing the business. First, what step? What are the first step, Kanna? If you want to do the business, planning. After planning, you have to worry about source of fund. Thereafter, collected fund you have to utilize. Therefore, long term as well as short term, working capital management as well as capital budgeting you have to do. Capital budgeting also called what? Investment decision. And last one is what? What? After everything is over, will your business will go smoothly? Yes, we have to undergo risk. Very good, Pooja. So we should know always any business risk will be there. Now we are having what? Huge risk for any business point of view. Okay, so we should be in the position to Ram. You deleted. Very good. You got the wrong answer. Now risk involved. You should know what? How to manage the risk. Yes, correct, correct. Manoj also correct. So how we have to manage the risk? So always we are under risk. Now we are under risk only. Okay. Therefore, what are all the things you have to do? First, you have to do planning. Second one, working capital you have to worry. Source of fund. Second one is source of fund. Third one, long term and short term investment. And we should know how to manage the risk. So this is what one we have to do. If you want to be a business person, we have to analyze all those things. Now, what and all we discussed? First one, plan, source of fund, one hand short term working capital, another hand long term capital budgeting, and the last one is risk. Then, easy way to understand the same working capital, okay, the investment, short term, long term, everything, okay. Now, so now you can be in the position to understand. You won't forget also. Now easy or not? See, looking like Pooja only, no? First step is for planning. Second one, source of fund. Next, we have to invest the fund in short term as well as long term. In case of short term, that investment is called what? Working capital management. If I am going to invest in long term, then it is called a what? Capital budgeting, also called a what? Investment decision. Then, whenever you are going to do the business, always risk will be there. Therefore, you should know how to manage the risk. Then, these are all the things are called five roles or functions of CFO. What are all the five major roles of CFO or five major functions of CFO? These are all the five major roles of CFO. What are all the five major roles? So the person is called what? Pooja is called what? CFO now. Clear? So what are all the five major roles of CFO? Planning, source of fund, working capital management, investment decision, and risk management. These are all what? Five major roles of CFO. Clear? So these are all the manner you have to prepare for the theory part. So as of now, we have completed working capital, that is what we have completed, what they're called, basic concept in financial management. Shall I quickly, even though time is up, shall I quickly review what are all the other important questions based on the past examination? Shall we review? Yeah. Kindly note down the important questions out of the first topic. Now, basic aspects of financial management. It's a frequently asked 3-mark question or 4-mark question. Once they asked functions of financial management, listen here, basic aspect is also called functions of financial management. Okay, basic aspect is also called one functions of financial management. So many students in that attempt, they are not able to write what is called a function, or they wrote something else. Therefore, you should be very careful. Basic aspect is also called functions of financial management. Next, characteristics of source of fund. It's a frequently asked question. Objectives of financial management. Frequently asked a question. Objectives of the financial management. Difference between profit maximization and wealth maximization. Many times they asked. November 2006, May 2009, November 10, May 15, 17, 18, once in MTP also. Clear? So many times they asked. Argument in favor of profit maximization. 2-mark question. Argument against wealth maximization. Arguments against wealth maximization. 2-mark question. Next, profit maximization is not an operationally feasible criterion. I'll repeat, profit maximization is not an operationally feasible criterion. That is also important question. Nothing but against profit maximization you have to write. Why profit maximization is not much important. Next, role of CFO. Next, 9 emerging issues which affect the future role of CFO. That is also important question. 9 emerging issues which affect the future role of CFO. What are all the 9 emerging issues which affect the future roles of CFO? First one, if you want to answer also note it down. Globalization. Second one, strategy. Third one, stakeholders management. Next, technology, talent and transformation. Technology, talent and transformation. Next, regulation, risk and reporting. Regulation, risk and reporting. These are all the 9 emerging issues which affect the future roles of CFO. నిమోనిక్ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ నోట్ ఇట్ డౌన్ GSTR జిఎస్టీ రిటర్న్ జిఎస్టీఆర్ జిఎస్ స్క్వయర్ టీ క్యూబ్ ఆర్ క్యూబ్ ఎస్ దివ్య గుడ్ జిఎస్ స్క్వయర్ టూ ఎస్ హ్యాస్టకమ్ టీ క్యూబ్ టీటీటీ ఆర్ క్యూబ్ జిఎస్టీఆర్ ఓకే నిమోనిక్ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ నోట్ ఇట్ డౌన్ GSTR so that for the purpose of easy reference GS 2 thereafter 3 T cube R cube okay 9 emerging issue also important next important question financial management versus financial accounting financial management versus financial accounting financial management versus financial accounting now one more thing I will tell thereafter I can complete concept based theory question is it possible for it to address or not we'll check identify the appropriate objectives of financial management it's a commonly committed mistake that is also you have to note it down objectives of financial management is different aspects of financial management is different in general in the examination student used to interchange aspects as well as objective objective represent profit maximization wealth maximization aspects represent procurement of fund and effective utilization of fund you should be very careful okay so two aspects two objectives don't get the confusion aspects also called functions functions of financial management okay now identify the following items under the appropriate objectives of financial management what are the objectives two objectives one is profit maximization another one is wealth maximization so you have to identify the following item will comes under the profit or wealth maximization shall we try now today I'm going to post in my telegram I'll give the link also important questions for the entire financial management and financial management winning strategy last minute revision strategy already I posted the youtube video also kindly watch I'll repeat financial management last minute revision strategy already I posted okay last week it's already posted in my youtube channel in the playlist it's available in intermediate column it's available fm financial management last minute revision strategy kindly watch so that a category item b category item c category item you can be the person to understand you can make a note also accordingly you can prepare every segment what are all important I give and question wise also what are all the questions you have to refer theory question as well as practical question today after the class I am going to post in my telegram those questions also kindly download and study properly okay so topic important topics and all I have posted in youtube channel and important questions okay with the mark wise I am going to post today in my telegram channel very good Ajit has already watched it seems good now shall we start identify the following item it is the intention begin starting the business which one is intention begin starting the business profit maximization it serves as a production against risk which one serves as a production against risk profit maximization it helps to increase the market price of the company's common stock comes under wealth maximization I'll repeat it helps to increase the market price of company's common stock comes under what wealth maximization Sapnaji correct only good future is uncertain so it is required to meet the future contingencies that will comes under profit maximization future is uncertain so it is required to meet the future contingency which one is in profit maximization it helps various resources are put to economical and efficient use that comes under wealth maximization I'll repeat it helps various resources are put to economical and effective efficient use that will comes under the wealth maximization next it cannot be sole object of the company which one is which one should not be the sole object of the company profit maximization it is a vague concept and means difficult to means differently to different people it's a vague concept and means differently to different people which one is profit maximization. Yes, Yamini. Good. It is a narrow concept. Which one? Profit maximization is a narrow concept. Next one. It indicates how wealth management is doing on behalf of stakeholders. That comes under the wealth maximization. It promotes employees' wealth and to increase customer satisfaction. That is also comes under wealth maximization. So, these are all the things, post exam questions with respect to basic concept. Hope you enjoyed post exam questions also. Am I right? All post exam questions I have given in the packet size theory book. Kindly refer the book. Here side headings will be there. For development purpose, extra development purpose, kindly go through the LMR book so that you can write the sufficient point also. Okay. And the first half of the packet size book, I have given all the theory questions with the answer. And second half, I have given formulas and the format for your better revision. So for the entire FM as a whole. So make use of the book properly. Clear? Hope you enjoyed today's session. Wish you all the best. Don't waste the time. Okay. Study properly. Take proper notes also. Okay. Bye-bye. Enjoy.